movie for our group project is Coach Carter, and I'm going to provide you guys with a summary. Coach Carter is a film based on a basketball coach who returns to his former high school named Richmond High. He looks to turn a troubled group of boys on a basketball team to a group of young men and great players. There are seven main characters in the film. Coach Carter, who is the basketball coach, Junior, Kenyon, Lyle, Cruz, Worm, and Damon, who is Coach Carter's son. When Coach Carter first arrives to his former high school, he watches them play a basketball game before he takes the job, and he quickly realizes that they do not work together good and they needed some guidance. Coach Carter quickly steps in and begins to discipline the team. He teaches them the importance of showing up on time, abiding by team rules, and also maintaining the 2.3 GPA. The team buys into what Coach Carter is selling, and they turn around a losing season to a winning season, and they reach the championship for the high school. The two specific sports psychology areas that we pointed out in the film was goal setting and group cohesion. Goal setting was attaining a specific standard of proficiency of a task, usually within a specific time limit. Group cohesion refers to the degree which members of a group work together to achieve common goals.
It's loud. How many games did you guys win last season?
Like 4 wins, 22 losses.
Sir. I'm going to give you contracts. If you sign and honor your side of them, we are going to be successful.
Damn, do I get a signing bonus for signing this contract?
Yes, sir. You get to become a winner.
What Coach Carter wanted to achieve by goal setting was that if you follow through and complete your goals, you will be winners. The goal setting caused one of the main dramas of the whole film, which was the lockout. The players had to sign contracts that stated their goals and how to achieve them, but they weren't meeting them, so practice and games stopped until they met all of their goals. This method was very effective because the team never lost until they got into the playoffs. Several of their players went on to play college ball, and most of them graduated high school, which was very surprising at Richmond High. This film shows exactly how important goal setting is, especially off the field and off the court. It does a good job of showing how important it is to communicate exactly what you want when you're setting the goals, because that would have prevented the lockout in the first place. I agree with Coach Carter's methods that goal setting should be used in this situation. And I also agree that he should have been the one setting the goals, because the kids would have set their goals way too easy so that they could have easily accomplished them. He does have extreme measures though, like the completely stopping the team from playing or practicing. But he proved that winning isn't everything, and school should be the first priority when you're a high school athlete.
Sir, they can cut the chain off the door, but they can't make us play.
We've decided we're gonna finish what you started, sir.
Yeah, so leave us be, coach. We got shit to do, sir.
Coach Carter uses group cohesion to prove that everyone succeeds and fails together and that they are a team. This is shown in several scenes throughout the film. One is the first game where they learn to trust each other on the court. They also show it while running and doing push-ups, which develops cohesion because they work together and they push each other. It's also shown when Cruz attempts to get back on the team, but he fails in getting all of his push-ups and gassers done. But Lyle steps up, shows great cohesion throughout the group, and helps him achieve his goal. They also show commitment to each other and Coach Carter, along with the teamwork that they developed when they finished their academic work, even when everyone else said that they didn't have to. All these scenes show great group cohesion, and they're all very powerful messages to get out to the public. Group cohesion is a very effective and practical skill that Coach Carter needed to instill. The team is an inner city team that had no previous success, and they always played individual basketball. They really needed to form a team to have a chance and succeed. The movie obviously shows that Coach Carter succeeded in making a team, and it shows exactly what a cohesive team can accomplish compared to an individual team. Coach Carter formed this cohesion through conditioning, being very sarcastic, and asserting his will and his way. He used extreme measures to help build team cohesion and to be successful, but it did work. Sometimes being extreme is the only way to help. However, this isn't the best coaching style for a high school basketball team. Most of the time, you don't want to be this demanding of them. But in this case, it worked very well.
Mr. Cruz, I'm impressed with what you've done, but you came up short. You owe me 80 suicides and 500 push-ups. Please leave my gym. Thanks, Clyde. Gentlemen, see you tomorrow.
I'll do push-ups for him. You said we're a team. One person struggles, we all struggle. One player triumphs, we all triumph, right?
I'll do some. I'll run suicides too.
We're going to use the sport psychology area of group cohesion displayed in the movie and incorporate that into the role of the collegiate strength and conditioning coach. The new season starts in the summer when brand new recruits are coming in for summer workouts. It is the job of the upperclassmen to take in the new recruits and show them the way the team works, the program works, and the expectations of the program. We'll divide lifting groups by position, wide receivers, linemen, defensive backs, etc., into 3 to 4 players. Each group has an upperclassman leader. Each group also has at least one lowerclassman, one incoming freshman. In those groups and in each lift, those upperclassmen have the responsibility of teaching this program's lifts and teaching proper form to assist the head coaches and the assistant coaches in building strength and conditioning for each player. To further grow group cohesion, that same group are put into lockers next to each other. Also, after each lift, upperclassmen are then required to lead a group stretch. That's taught from the head coaches and the assistant coaches to the upperclassmen. Upperclassmen then lead it and teach the lowerclassmen. Each upperclassman is equally responsible and accountable for their lowerclassmen's actions. Upperclassmen understand the programs and the coaches' expectations of the players. Therefore, it's the upperclassmen's responsibilities as leaders to pass down the team's core values. One player's discipline is the group's discipline.
Leave the gym right now.
For what?
I'll ask you one last time to leave the gym before I help you leave.
Before you what? Do you even know who I am?
From what I can see, a very confused and scared young man.
Scared of who? Scared of you? I'm supposed to be scared of you? Nigga, I ain't scared of nobody. I would lay your ass out.
I don't think so.
Get off me! Teachers ain't supposed to touch students.
I'm not a teacher. I'm the new basketball coach.
Yeah. see no changes. Wake up in the morning and I ask myself, is life worth living? Should I blast myself? I'm tired of being poor and even worse, I'm black. My stomach hurts, so I'm looking for a purse to snatch. Cops give a damn about a Negro. Pull a trigger, kill a nigga, he's a hero. Get it back to the kids, who the hell cares? One less hungry mouth on the welfare. First ship them, don't let them deal with brothers. Give them guns, step back, watch them kill each other. It's time to fight back, that's what Huey said. Two shots in the dark, now Huey's dead.